Happy Wednesday to you. Thank you so much for joining us here on CN2 Now. I'm Lucas McFadden. First up tonight, a Lancaster County home engulfed in flames. Take a look. Indianland Fire District, as well as the Wesley Chapel, Waxhaw Volunteer, Fort Mill, and then Wyck Fire Departments all responded to that single-family house fire. Fire crews say they encountered heavy flames throughout the first floor. Firefighters say they were able to make a push from the basement at the back side of the house and were able to then put out the fire. According to South Carolina Law Enforcement Division, agents there charging 64-year-old Stephen Boat with forgery and financial transaction fraud. According to the warrant in September of 2023, Boat used an unnamed individual's Wells Fargo credit card to withdraw $800. The warrant says camera footage captured Boat as the person making these withdrawals. Later in October of 2023, investigators say he also forged the signature of another individual as a seller on the title of a 2018 Chevy Malibu. Detectives say he later then transferred the title to his name and then sold the vehicle to CarMax. In Chester County, 41-year-old Ronald Wilson was arrested and charged after a search warrant uncovered multiple firearms and illegal drugs at a home. According to the Chester County Sheriff's Office, on Thursday, March the 14th, deputies executed that search warrant at a residence off of Whitetail Drive off of Old York Road there in Chester. During the search, Wilson was found to be in possession of approximately 85 grams of a substance believed to be marijuana, about 20 grams of a substance believed to be meth, 34 firearms, and hundreds of rounds of ammunition and multiple suppressors for those firearms. The search warrant was executed to further an investigation following a domestic disturbance that occurred at the residence earlier in the day. Wilson was charged with domestic violence, possession with intent to distribute marijuana, trafficking meth, and firearms possession during the commission of a violent crime. Coming up on CN2 Now, we will hear from some talented students from Westminster Catawba as they share details of their production of Singing in the Rain. And just ahead, we will hear from Tender Hearts Ministries as it celebrates 20 years of serving the community.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
When it comes to prescription medications and health needs, Rock Hill residents have been turning to Good Pharmacy for over 50 years.
I've been coming to Good Pharmacy since we came to Rock Hill in 1984, and I would not change pharmacists for anything.
With their knowledgeable staff, you can always trust that your prescription will be filled with complete confidence and care for your health. Good Pharmacy, conveniently located at the corner of Ebenezer Road and Camden Avenue.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
We know the type. You like to start early, finish late, make lemon squares, and make payments to the college fund from anywhere in the house. We know you rely on Comporium for the things you rely on most, like a view of the backyard. That's just a bunny, and hundreds of channels to watch, whenever you want. So you may think of us as just your internet company, but we're more like the I didn't know they could do all that company. Comporium, always ready.
In 1954, Toy Green began serving families as if they were his own. And that continues today, more than 60 years later.
We are more than funeral directors. We're your friends, neighbors, and a family committed to serving yours. Whether it's pre-planning your own or planning a loved one's, we will help you plan the perfect service.
Our directors are also available to assist you long after the service has ended.
Here at Green Funeral Home, we're all about family.
And we're proud that tradition will continue for a fourth generation.
You're watching CN2 Now. Finding the perfect dress is a big part of the prom experience, but not everyone can afford that expensive dress. That's why Tender Hearts Ministries is holding its fourth annual Cinderella's Closet Free Prom Dress event.
Let's get to this free prom dress event. Again, free.
Yes.
The fourth annual. Give us all the details.
So this coming Saturday, March 23rd, from 11 o'clock until 2 o'clock, young ladies who are going to prom bring their student ID with them, and they can come, and they get everything for prom. And when I say everything, I'm talking they'll pick out their dress first, then matching shoes, from there matching jewelry, matching handbags, and then they get the toiletries that go with that, because we want them to have everything they need to make their day special. So, and it's 100% free of charge. And it's such an exciting event, because you see a lot of times dads will come in and say, I'm working two jobs, I can't make ends meet, and thank you for helping my daughter get to prom. You know, this is very rewarding and exciting for us. And this year, we actually have a little something extra that we're doing, because a lot of times they'll say, well, what about the guys? You know, and we hadn't really thought about that. So this year, we do have suits and dress shoes for guys as well. So if there's any guys that want to come to Cinderella's Closet, we have suits, ties, shoes, the whole nine yards for a guy, too. So it's just kind of a different spin this year. But again, it's all free. There's no qualification. Show up, have your student ID with you, and we will partner you with a fashion stylist for the day. And she'll be their guide to take them through and just help them pick out that perfect prom dress for them.
I mean, Ansley, we're at a loss for words. It's unbelievable that you provide this experience. And that example you gave for that family, that again, a family, a single parent, two family income, grandparents working multiple jobs to afford a prom dress. That is one night to get dressed up and experience what all young people should be able to experience before they're slapped in the face with the real world. You have more than 900 dresses and accessories. Mm-hmm. It's also first come, first serve.
It is. Okay. You know, we have sizes 0 to +size. So we have every size imaginable. And there are, like I said, a little over 900 dresses. So
where did they come from?
Donations. So we usually start the end of the year saying, hey, prom's coming up. Donate those dresses. Clean out your closets, ladies. And because of that, they just start rolling in. And as they roll in our donation area, we just lay them to the side for the special event.
So this is going to be first come, first serve. This is for students from York County and Chester County.
That is correct.
You have to bring your school ID. It's this Saturday, March the 23rd from 11 to 2.
Right.
And what's the location?
So it's 145 Blackburn Street, York, and it's in our new events area. So we have about 8,000 square feet that they can just come in and try on everything and just feel like a princess for a day.
Is it too late for folks to donate suits for the guys or dresses and accessories for the ladies?
Not at all. So we do ask that if they're donating at this point, that it come to the 145 Blackburn Street. But you can donate really to the day of, and it will still get hung on the rack, or the shoes will get put out. So if there's anybody, you know, who wants to clean out their closet and bring it to us, we are thrilled. My thoughts always go to, what dress, what shoes are in your closet that might fit this girl and be the perfect dress for them? So I always encourage people, clean it out, bring it to us, donate, because that could be the one for a girl in need.
And it can change their whole life.
Absolutely.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Stop holding on to some of those memories and the size that you were in high school. Take a picture. You have pictures to live by. You're freezing time. But to your point, give that dress a new life on a new young lady. And the same thing with the suit with a guy. I mean, I will tell you, for the guys, no longer are the tuxedos really in style. They're always in style, I should say.
Right.
But now these suits are tailored and they look really great. So applaud you all for thinking about the guys as part of this experience.
And sometimes it's harder for men to let go of their suits. So, and no pun intended, but it really is. So that is something that we have less of. So if a man wants to clean out his ties and his shirts and suits, we would love to have those, because although we have over 900 dresses for the ladies, we probably only have about 50 suits for the guys. So it would be great to have the men clean out their closets too.
Ansley, take us back 20 years ago.
Sure. Well, I'm going to tell you, 20 years ago, I was a single mom with two littles, and it was something that God had just burdened my heart to do. I was in a situation where I tried to get some assistance. I was working three jobs trying to make ends meet, and it basically was denied because I made too much money. And my heart was to just help other single moms who were in that same situation of just needing some assistance, a hand up, not a hand out. And when God burdened my heart about it, I went and talked to my pastor and his wife, and, you know, the rest is history. From there, we started our board of directors, did a 501c3, and the past 20 years, all I can say is God has given the increase. And now we are very blessed because we're in four cities. We're in Chester, Clover, Rock Hill, and York. And one of the biggest things that Tender Hearts does, and I don't know that a lot of people know it, but we have over 100 partnerships, and last year we were able to give over $80,000 in gift cards to our thrift stores. So Tender Hearts is not just about Tender Hearts. We are about community. We are about the other nonprofits who may have that mom or dad that needs interview attire, or, you know, they need shoes or things like that. So we're also giving back to the other nonprofits, church bodies, schools, the resource officers that, you know, say, hey, the kid came in flip-flops in January and we need shoes for this kid. So when you give to our four thrift stores, you're actually giving back to community, because the item might be sold and it rolled into ministry, but the item might be donated to a child or an adult in need, and they may use that gift card. It's just kind of like a Walmart card. You walk in, you go to the register with dignity. They can try the clothes on and see if they fit, and then they'll pay for them bagged up, and nobody really ever knows that it was a free of charge item.
Doing it with dignity.
Yes,
that's what it's all about.
Dignity is huge.
The mission of Tender Hearts today, is it still the same as what the mission was 20 years ago? And what is your core mission?
We started out as Tender Hearts Girls Home Inc., obviously just to serve, you know, girls, women. And it has changed. 3 years ago, we opened the City of York's first men's shelter. So in addition to serving women and children, we now serve men as well. All throughout the year, we have different huge events. We do National Night Out in conjunction with the police department. Last year, we had collected around 900 book bags to give out with school supplies, Cinderella's Closet, Christmas toys. We do homebound senior citizens food delivery, which is also free of charge to the seniors, the food and the delivery. And that's in Western, we serve the Western York County part with that.
In a calendar year between Western York County, York County in general, and Chester County, how many people do you serve in a calendar year?
In a calendar year, we serve a little over 2,000. We kind of ran back and did our numbers last year, and last year we had served a little over 10,000 unduplicated individuals. So this year, I'm going to say we're going to be between 12 and 13,000 unduplicated individuals in the last 20 years.
Again, the Cinderella's Closet Free Prom Dress event is this Saturday, March the 23rd, starting at 11 o'clock in the morning at Tender Hearts Ministries right there on Blackburn Street in York. It is first come, first serve.
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
From my first watch I purchased as a teenager, which still runs today, to the diamond ring I surprised my wife with, which she still talks about today, a gift from Norman Hagee is as good as it gets. Whether it's elegant timepieces by Bulova, Caravelle, and Bel Air, or ornamental ironwork-inspired Southern Gates collection, or dazzling fine jewelry, a gift from Hagee is backed by over 60 years of family-owned and operated experience. Norman Hagee Jewelers, for gifts as good as it gets.
For over 60 years, Gill Insurance has been lucky enough to serve the wonderful people of York County. Everything we do is done with the best interest of our customers and our community in mind. We want to thank each and every one of you who've trusted us to insure their most important assets.
Call on the Gill agencies in Rock Hill, Fort Mill, and now in Mount Pleasant. Independent agents proudly representing Auto Owners Insurance Company.
When your gutters need repair, call the company that's been providing roofing and gutter services since 1939, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company. We offer full gutter service, from simple repairs to complete replacement, gutter guards, and even gutter cleanings. In fact, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company was voted Charlotte's best gutter service company by the readers of The Observer. When it comes to your gutter needs, call the best. H&S Roofing and Gutter Company, serving the Carolinas since 1939.
Welcome back to CN2 Now. Westminster Catawba Christian School is gearing up for its spring production, so grab your umbrella as those students are bringing to life what is considered as the greatest movie musical of all time, Singing in the Rain.
So Stokes, is there a little like, oh my gosh, people know at least that iconic song, that iconic dance, and we have to bring it to life and make it our own?
I mean, there are definitely some fears with it because I had actually never watched Singin' in the Rain prior to auditioning, my bad. But when I like looked it up and I see all these articles, it's like top 10 greatest movies of all time. Number one, Singin' in the Rain. I'm like, okay, that's, you know, a little wake up call. But, you know, I mean, there's a lot of fears in it, but there's a reason it's considered really good or the greatest. And it's because it's such a great production. And so when we're able to put that work into it and able to sort of create it in our own way, it's almost not easy in a sense, but it's comforting because you know it's going to be good. And so that has brought a lot of just comfort in that part.
Now, this is not your first production with Westminster. You've done several productions before.
Yes, sir. This is my second musical production, my third production with Westminster.
Now, your fellow actor over here, Cesar, I understand you were a techie, right? And they had a position that came available in one production, and you kind of got thrown into that production. And then you came back to audition for Singing in the Rain. What was the deal with that? What did you like? Did you catch the acting bug?
Yes, sir. So when I moved here, I never really liked theater. And then a lot of my friends were part of the musical, and they invited me to join several times. I was like, I don't know. I don't really feel it. And then eventually during Tech Week, I was thrown in there, and someone couldn't fill the role, and so I had to step up and learn a few lines. And that whole experience was just wonderful to me, and it motivated me to learn more and like audition for this musical.
Now, the iconic song we just heard, who is responsible for singing and dancing to that one? You are, Cesar?
Yes, sir, yeah.
I mean, that is one of the most recognizable songs and dances of all of entertainment. Is it a little overwhelming? Because I mean, I'm a little nervous for you, but I'm also not a singer or a dancer or an actor, but I know you have the chops to do so.
Yes, at first it's a little bit nerve-wracking, but after so many rehearsals, it doesn't feel too bad anymore, so I'm really excited for it.
What was your reaction, Stokes, when Halle said, this is what we're going to do in the spring, Singing in the Rain? I know you said you weren't familiar with it, but when you realized that you not only have to act, sing, and then dance, because you have not, you don't have a deep dancing background.
No, not much.
Resume. I'm going to let Halle share more about that in a second, but.
Well, I mean, Newsies was really fun. Didn't have to dance. I got, you know, the get out of jail free card with that one. They just kind of threw me to the side and were like, you're doing great. And so when I heard we were doing Singin' in the Rain, a lot more contemporary musical, I was like, you know what? 1 year is great. Halle, you are fine. You have people that will work with you. And I said, no, theater's not my thing. And then, you know, during the summer, I was like, it might be worth trying. And so started doing tap with Cesar at Dance Revolution. down the street, and that's been super helpful. It built up my confidence a lot, and now I have a new skill that I can just, you know, pull out at parties with my tap shoes and be like, whoa, guys, you want to see me tap? And it goes great.
Hey, that is an icebreaker. I've never seen one before. Well, let's bring in Halee Christopher, who, again, always loves to give her students the spotlight. But we enjoy our interview so much with you. You were sharing with me just a moment ago before we flipped the mics on that these two gentlemen had zero dancing abilities and skills. That's not a knock on both of y'all. Y'all are talented. But you told them, if you want to do this, you have to be able to tap dance.
Right.
And they did it.
And they did it. It is amazing to me how my students, no matter what the challenge I send to them, they rise to that occasion. And I'm really, really impressed with specifically these two and my two lead females as well. They have just... They are top-notch performers. And, you know, when we say things like, okay, we're going to do a paradiddle here, which is a really difficult tap thing for somebody who is a beginner. And they're like, oh, yeah. And I'm like, oh, thank you for taking tap dance lessons. Thank you so much. I've really been impressed with the way that they've come about this, their leadership, the way that they encourage others, even the ones who did not take lessons over the summer, anything else like that. Specifically, my four leads have just been very encouraging and take people to the side and help them. And I think that's what's unique about Westminster. We have 6th through 12th grade all in cast together. And, you know, we do have to have fewer middle schoolers because we're doing the bloomies, but it's a mentoring situation. So one of the questions we asked off air was, how do you get so many guys? And I think that they're here because other people before them encouraged them and didn't make it awkward and made it something that, hey, let's find a new talent. Let's do something different. And I think that the legacy that those students have held is why they're here and why I'll have more next year.
Westminster Catawba Christian School, the theater department there is presenting Singing in the Rain. It is this weekend. It is Friday, March the 22nd at 7 p.m., Saturday, March the 23rd at 2 and 7, right there at the upper campus off of India Hook Road. Halee, in case folks are not familiar with Singing in the Rain, and in all reality, Stokes, I'm the same way. I know that song, and that's about it. What's the gist of the production?
So basically, these two are best friends from childhood, and they grow up, but Cosmo actually has to take a backseat, so Stokes has to take a backseat to Don's rise in fame, and fame really gets to him. He goes to Hollywood, and he and Lena Lamont are the silent film stars. And then he meets someone, Kathy, who is humble, who is kind, and he sees a whole nother world. And so because of that, it really changes his perspective, and that ego starts to have to take a back seat. And that's what this show's all about.
A musical, you're not only singing, you're dancing, and you're acting. What is the hardest part for you, Stokes, and then same thing for you, Cesar, to have to, like, really capture?
I think for Cosmo, he has a lot of physical comedy. So he is running around and doing flips and jumping over people and doing a bunch of random stuff and tapping. So there's just a lot going on, and it's sort of – he's a chaotic good is how I see him. And so – portraying that, it kind of is how I am in life. So it's kind of easy in that sense, but also there's a lot of stuff, like you really have to capture the audience with a lot of your numbers that you do, because you got to be funny, and sometimes it can be hard to be funny. And
again, so, Singing in the Rain will take place this March the 22nd and March the 23rd at Westminster Catawba Christian School. It's the upper campus located there on India Hook Road.
We know the type. You like to start early, finish late, make lemon squares, and make payments to the college fund from anywhere in the house. We know you rely on Comporium for the things you rely on most, like a view of the backyard. That's just a bunny, and hundreds of channels to watch.
whenever you want. So you may think of us as just your internet company, but we're more like the I didn't know they could do all that company. Comporia, always ready.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
In 1954, Toy Green began serving families as if they were his own. And that continues today, more than 60 years later.
We are more than funeral directors. We're your friends, neighbors, and a family committed to serving yours. Whether it's pre-planning your own or planning a loved one's, we will help you plan the perfect service.
Our directors are also available to assist you long after the service has ended.
Here at Green Funeral Home, we're all about family.
And we're proud that tradition will continue for a fourth generation.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
This is CN2 Now. The results are in for the Fort Mill school bond referendum vote. Ballots were cast in Fort Mill on Tuesday, March the 19th, on a $204 million bond referendum. The money will pay for a new middle school and early childhood development center, technology upgrades, property for future schools, and upkeep at existing schools. There were 2,437, or 64%, who voted in favor of the bond, and 1,370, or 36%, who opposed it. Here's our latest picture of the day. For the second time in 3 years, Great Falls High School principal Dr. Jamal Sanders has been named the 1A Principal of the Year by the South Carolina Athletic Administrators Association. The award is presented each year to the principal who has shown outstanding leadership in support of athletics at both the local and state levels. Additionally, Great Falls was one of five schools in the state to receive the sportsmanship certificate from the South Carolina High School League. And that will do it for this edition of CN2 Now. Thank you so much for joining us. We will be back bright and early at 6 a.m. for Palmetto Mornings right here on CN2. That's Reporting Cable Channel 102 and on the radio at WRHI FM 100.5.
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? Yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
When your gutters need repair, call the company that's been providing roofing and gutter services since 1939, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company. We offer full gutter service, from simple repairs to complete replacement, gutter guards, and even gutter cleanings. In fact, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company was voted Charlotte's best gutter service company by the readers of The Observer. When it comes to your gutter needs, call the best. H&S Roofing and Gutter Company, serving the Carolinas since 1939.
It's the Great Easter Egg Classic. I want candy. With over 35,000 eggs.
I want an Easter egg. I want an Easter egg. I want an Easter
How about you? Do you want to meet the Easter Bunny and search for thousands of Easter eggs on Thursday, March 28th at Cherry Park?
I do.
You don't.
I do.
All 10 runs for ages 2 to 11 are free, starting at 1:30 p.m. with an explosion of over 2,000 special prize eggs.
I want candy.
The Great Easter Egg Classic. The Great Easter Egg Classic.